the heavy metal kings of England's Spinal Tap.
Are you a heavy metal fan?
Yes, I'm yeah.
Heavy metal. What's the appeal?
You just listen to it and it gives you a good feeling.
Awfully loud.
Tell us how people feel today.
Little girl, baby.
Nobody says anything about no carpet or nothing.
What happens to you physically?
It just makes you feel like you kick ass.
You're sweet, but you're just 4 feet. You still got your baby teeth. You're too young and too well hooked. I'm gonna rock you. I'm gonna rock you.
Okay, bring the slides now. We'll work on this.
There you go. A little bit more. Yeah, yeah. Let's get in there. Yeah.
It's like you become one with the guys in the band. I mean, there's no division. You just, the music just unites people with the players.
Rock and roll!
Labels and all that shit, it's all music, and that's the hallmark of what we do. It's all music.
Yeah. Now, the band that you originally...
We were always in it, Lovely Lads.
I was in the Creatures.
And then we joined up, we made the Originals.
The Originals. We had to change our name, though, because there was another group called the Originals, also in the East End, and so we had to call ourselves the New Originals.
Right, and then they became the Regulars.
Regulars, yeah. We dropped the name Originals altogether. We went to Holland, so this kid and I, and Ronnie Pudding on a bass.
And Ronnie Pudding?
Well, he left to do missionary work in Namibia.
He did a record, too.
He did one record, yeah. It was a solo album. What was it called?
Doesn't Anybody Speak English?
That's
right. It's a great record, yeah. Good record. He was a prodigy, though. He was 2 years old. He performed at Albert Hall when he was two.
And so we returned to England, and we became, well, at that time, was it Thamesman? Was it next?
Yeah.
We made one record, Give Me Some Money.
Stop wasting my time. You know what I want. You know what I need. Oh, maybe you don't. Do I have to come right flat out and tell you everything? Give me some money.
Stampy, you see, was our drummer.
The original drummer.
The original drummer. And he's not alive anymore.
He's a beautiful bloke, isn't he? Just great, beautiful, tall, blonde git, you know, just great drummer.
What happened to Stampy?
He died of in a bizarre gardening accident some years ago.
He was replaced by
a gent we call Stumpy Joe.
Stumpy Joe.
Eric Child.
And he's
Eric
a great Child. Drummer. A lot of people say, just look, it's a joke, but he's a great drummer.
No, he's a real good drummer.
He's Stumpy dead. Joe.
He's dead.
He's dead too.
Yeah, he died of an overdose of Sudafed.
I see.
Yeah, it's really ugly affair.
Then you had a third drummer?
Peter again. James Bond.
Well, you heard what happened to him. He was touring.
We were doing a summer festival.
Where was that?
Where was it?
The Isle of Lucy.
Isle of Lucy, Festival. And it was, we were not headliners or nothing at the time, and he exploded on stage. It was quite bizarre. He exploded, and all that was left was a little stain on his drum seat.
Yeah.
You know, it was really, it was quite fantastic. They thought it was part of the show, you know, this huge flash of green light, and a stain is left.
Yeah. It was you know, half a dozen people, you know, spontaneously combust every year.
Jesus, this better be Eddie.
Yep, this is it. St. Louis. So let's get checked in here.
Absolutely.
We've got seven suites in a row, away from the ice machines and the elevators.
I'm terrible, sir. I believe that's five suites is what was requested.
Seven suites.
Well, we're awfully booked at the moment. I'm terribly sorry. You know, we have the House of the Wiz.
Now, you listen to me, you twisted fruit. I want those suites, and I want them now, all right?
I don't like circling around.
That macho.
This is Spinal Tap, of course. This is Mr. Fabe.
Spinal Tap.
They want seven suites. We have five for them. I think we might be able to make an adjustment, but it'll have to be a mini suite.
Yes, what about...
What's a mini suite?
A mini suite is a single with an extra few feet to it. These are the minis.
Since we've inconvenienced you, how about a complimentary shrimp cocktail sent to your room?
All right.
Isn't that wonderful?
Yeah. Yes.
We'll be happy. In fact, you can have them now if you'd like. You can take them
right up. Turn them up.
Absolutely.
You stay away, all right?
I've read in the Rolling Stone, they've called, the last review I read, it called your music simple and brainless.
How can you call music simple and brainless if there are 10,000 young kids standing on their chairs screaming,
each one of them
wiggling
with
their
brains, each one of them with perfectly good brains?
Exactly.
You can't call that.
That's
I've
right.
seen a number of brains out there.
Right.
Take your belt off and go through again.
Oh,
sure. Thank you.
All right.
Now, I meant to tell you last night you were great. You were really selling.
Sir, you want to step through?
Strap me.
Do you have any other metal objects on you, please?
Yeah.
Could you kindly put them on the table?
Hold me a moment, mate.
Just get the metal out.
Move your phone, mate.
Non-stop service to Nashville is now ready.
Sir, I'm sorry. You're going to have to step over here, please. Right up against the wall. Right over here. Do you have any artificial plates or limbs?
Not that I know of, no.
All right. Now stand up, please.
Over the studs and my shirt. Right.
Sir, I think that... could you take that out and set it right here on the...
Hello. I thought I told you to hold all calls.
Oh, all right.
Yeah. Hello, Mr. K. How are you?
Oh, yeah?
Oh, really?
Just hold on a minute. I have to share this with the boys. This is fucking amazing.
Is that?
This company here is telling us that we can't release the album here.
What? Wait, what are you talking about? Wait.
Smell the glove.
Smell the glove. Know what the reason is?
No.
The reason is the cover.
Oh, what? Shit.
Yeah,
that's the greatest cover we ever had. What's wrong with the
cover? The jobbers.
That's the greatest cover we ever did.
I agree with you absolutely. But the jobbers won't rack it.
Let me understand. Smell the glove. Is that the album that's the current?
That's the album we're over here to fucking push, isn't it?
What's
well,
the album
allegedly,
cover?
The album cover is sexist because it shows a woman. It shows a woman, a very pretty woman, I might add,
yeah.
A very pretty woman on all fours,
yeah,
with a collar around her neck,
right.
Being asked to sniff a glove. What's sexist about that?
The bigger the cushion, the sweeter the cushion. That's what I said. The looser the waistband, the deeper the quicksand, or so I have read. My baby fits me like a flesh tuxedo. I like to sink her with my pink torpedo.
Here we are then.
Where?
New Jersey.
Yeah, it's great.
What's the smell?
Wonderful.
What is the smell?
I can't believe it.
Yeah, don't know. Sure. It smells like
Are you reading Yes, I Can?
Yes, I
by
am.
By Sammy Davis Jr.? Ha! That's some book. You know what the title of that book should really be? It should be Yes, I Can if Frank Sinatra says it's okay. Really, because
great.
Frank, he calls
great.
The shows
great.
For all those guys. Did you get to the part yet where Sammy's coming out of the Copacabana at about 3 o'clock in the morning?
Fucking limeys.
Rock musicians,
yeah.
You
well,
know.
They just, you know, they don't understand. They don't appreciate the man because they haven't, you know, they get all they want, you know. See, if you've been in love and you've lost the way Frank has, then, you know, you could appreciate it.
Send
what the
shit,
fuck is that?
Christ.
Oh, it's just a dead person.
You must have ran over Frank.
Have you driven this before?
You ever drive Frank?
No, I never drove him. I picked up a car that he'd been in the night before. And the essence was still there. The magic was still there.
And then you got the Mile High Jam in Denver.
Oh, the Mile High, that's
yeah.
the one.
I won't be able to be there. For yeah. that. I've got
what?
To go to London for
oh, don't. Don't take
nah.
off. Oh, shit.
No, I've got it. My uncle's going to die.
What, again?
Yeah.
Listen to this.
You got your own tape machine?
I've got you under my skin.
That's crazy.
It's a bit of a departure from the kind of thing you normally
yeah.
play.
It's real delicate, you know. It's supposed to be like I wrote it for clavinet and bass clarinet.
Yeah.
So it's like, you know, French horn.
It shows a whole other side of you.
Yeah, it's a suite actually. It's a four part suite. We're gonna put it on the record, but it don't fit on the record. So.
What's the name of this?
This part of it's called Lick My Love Pump. It's nice.
No, this isn't what you were commissioned to do. What you were commissioned to do is about 102 times bigger than this.
That's not true. That's not what I was commissioned to do. I brought you my sketches. You did not look at my sketches. You gave me one of your own.
Darling,
would
this
you like
is supposed
to see
be
that?
About 20 feet by 20 feet, about 25,000 pounds, and it comes down with a big hook in the middle of the auditorium.
Let me show you what one of your fellows gave me. What's this notation?
18 inches by 18 inches. What set is 18 inches?
The set that you've paid for is
18
inches.
Why can't you use your brain? What the fuck am I gonna do with this?
In ancient times, hundreds of years before the dawn of history, lived a strange race of people. The Druids. No one knows who they were. Or what they were doing. But their legacy remains. Hewn into the living rock. Oh, Stonehenge.
Stonehenge, where the
well, where the banshees live, and they do live well. Stonehenge, where a man's a man, and the children dance to the pipes of Pan. And you, my love, won't you take my hand? We'll go back in time to that mystic land.
Children of Stonehenge, 'neath the haunted moon, for fear that daybreak might come too soon.
Inwardly,
yeah. Yeah, can't
but
help.
I mean,
it's
I
in your blood. You can't stop.
I don't want to just get together another fucking band and go on the road. I couldn't work without these blokes now, you know. It's just... this is it, you know. I mean, I get along with these guys so great.
I played it perfect, didn't I?
As I understand it, you know, we're paying for this place by the hour.
No, it's a book
so
blocking.
It might be a good
it's
idea, you know, just once every 3 or 4 hours for us to get some fucking piece of music down on fucking tape, all right?
I wrote a fucking tape, Dory!
How?
Passes at it, you know, and
you
I said
16
it.
Tons of
no,
shit.
If he had been. If he had been.
Shut up!
You
shut up!
No, you're all yelling at each other, you're not you're gonna get anything.
Look, what are we gonna do now?
Try it on 12 string.
12 string? You can't play a buddy? 6 string!
Don't get me out of fucking fire!
The popularity of the group has waned a bit.
Well, yes, in
I mean, you were the last tour of them when you toured in the United States. You were playing 10,000 seat arenas.
Well,
now it looks like the places you've been booked into are 1,200 and 1,500 seat arenas.
Yeah, I don't think it's a question of the popularity of the group waning, but of its appeal becoming more selective.
It's the art, because we've come to a place in our music which we can really be proud of. You know, it's not just like garbage anymore. It was in the first few years.
Oh, yeah, but it was great garbage, you know.
It was fun garbage anyway.
It was popular garbage, too. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Every time it's been the end of the rainbow, there's been one more colour. You know, I like to say that. Thank you.
Yeah, very pretty.
Oh, I like that. That's sweet.